Today's Morning Mass is brought to you in part by these sponsors.
Good morning. Our opening song is number 185, Jesus is Risen, number 185.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather to celebrate the Eucharist today, we pause. We ask Jesus to forgive us our sins.
Lord Jesus, you suffered and died on a cross for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you rose gloriously from the dead, giving us the hope of eternal life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins. Bring us to life everlasting. Glory to God in the highest,
peace to people.
us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who gave us the Paschal mystery and a covenant you established for reconciling the human race, so dispose our minds, we pray, that we may celebrate by professing the faith we may express in deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from Acts of the Apostles. After the crippled man had been cured, while Peter and John were still speaking to the people, the priests, the captain of the temple guard, and the Sadducees confronted them. Disturbed, they were teaching the people and proclaiming in Jesus the resurrection of the dead. They laid hands on Peter and John and put them in custody until the next day, since it was already evening. But many of those who heard the word came to believe, and the number of men grew to about 5,000. On the next day, their leaders, elders, and scribes were assembled in Jerusalem with Annas the high priest, Caiaphas, John, Alexander, and all who were of the high priestly class. They brought them into their presence and questioned them, "By what power or by what name have you done this?" Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, answered them, "Leaders of the people and elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely, by what means he was saved, then all of you and all the people of Israel should know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name, this man stands before you healed. He is the stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved." The word of the Lord.
The responsorial psalm is, "The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone."
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, "His mercy endures forever." Let those who fear the Lord say, "His mercy endures forever."
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
O Lord, grant salvation. O Lord, grant prosperity. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light.
Stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. You may worthy of infinitely proclaim his holy gospel in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus revealed himself again to his disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. He revealed himself in this way. Together were Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, Zebedee's sons, and two others of his disciples. Simon Peter said to them, "I am going fishing." They said to him, "We also will come with you." So they went out and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. When it was already dawn, Jesus was standing on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, "Children, have you caught anything to eat?" They answered him, "No." So he said to them, "Cast a net over the right side of the boat, and you will find something." So they cast it and were not able to pull it in because of the number of fish. So the disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." When Simon Peter heard this, that it was the Lord, he tucked in his garment, for he was lightly clad, and jumped into the sea. The other disciples came in the boat, for they were not far from shore, only about 100 yards, dragging the net with fish. When they climbed out on shore, they saw a charcoal fire with fish on it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you have caught." So Simon Peter went over and dragged the net ashore, full of 153 large fish. Even though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come, have breakfast." And none of the disciples dared to ask him, "Who are you?" Because they realized it was the Lord. Jesus came over and took bread and gave it to them, and in like manner the fish. This was now the third time Jesus was revealed to his disciples after being raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus. I always find this time of the year a very exciting time as I listen to the readings from Scripture. I can't imagine what it was like for the apostles in those days after Jesus started appearing to them, but that's all they did is talk about it. And so we see in today's reading, Peter and John and some of the other apostles are out fishing, and typically they don't seem to catch anything. And they see this man on the shore, it's really Jesus, they're not sure he is, and he says, "Why don't you lower your nets on the other side?" And they do, and they catch so many fish. And then when they come to shore, Jesus has a fire burning there, he has some fish and bread on it, and he tells them to bring some of their fish, and they eat. And just, I can't imagine how excited they were to see him, and filled with disbelief, and talking about him wherever they met, and they heard stories of Jesus appearing to the two disciples on the road to Emmaus, and then he appeared to Peter and the 12, and now he appears to them a third time. I just bet it was a very exciting time. And then in the first reading today, after the Holy Spirit has come upon the apostles, Peter and John, we saw Wednesday where we're singing, walking and leaping, as Peter had cured that crippled man and sitting at the temple gate. And now the leaders of the Jewish people are very upset about all this talk about Jesus. And so they call Peter and John before the whole court and say, what are you doing? By what power do you have to cure this man? And Peter, who on Holy Thursday night was afraid to admit even to a servant girl that he was a follower of Jesus, now he stands before the whole big court and he says, "If you're accusing us or whatever, curing that sick man, that crippled man, it was Jesus of Nazareth whom you crucified. He is our Lord and Savior. He was chosen by God to be our Redeemer. And it's in his name that we preach and do the things we're doing. And it's by his power that crippled man was cured." In tomorrow's gospel, you can even hear where they After Jesus feeds the people, he takes Peter aside and gives him a chance to redeem himself for denying Jesus. And in the first reading, we'll see how the leaders of the court tell Peter and John, "We want you to stop talking about Jesus, and if you don't, we're going to get kind of tough with you." And Peter, who's no longer afraid, says, "You can throw us in jail if you want. You can kill us if you want, but we have to tell you what we know. Jesus, whom you crucified, he is raised from the dead. He is our Lord and Savior, and it's only through him that we can find salvation." So it's kind of neat to see how the big change that took place in Peter and the apostles, who are afraid to be known as followers of Jesus, now no matter where they go, they can't stop talking about him. And I just think it must have been very exciting in those times. And it's exciting for us too. For you second graders, Sunday is going to be a special day, isn't it? And I know you're excited. And I'm excited for you too, that you can receive Jesus. And I hope all the rest of you are excited this morning when you can come up and receive Jesus. It's the same Jesus that rose from the dead. It's the same Jesus who appeared to the two guys on the road to Emmaus. It's the same risen Jesus who shared the Peter and the 12 apostles, and he's present in our midst in Holy Communion. And we are so lucky to come up, hold our hands, and receive him. So be excited about it. Don't sit around like lumps on a log, but be excited about the fact that Jesus loves you and he's present with us, and then he wants us to go out and reflect his love to others by what we say and do. Let us stand and pray. O God, our Heavenly Father, Jesus appeared to his disciples a number of times after he rose from the dead, and he's present in our midst every time we celebrate the Eucharist. Help us to recognize his presence and proclaim his love to others. Grant us this, Lord, and the favors we ask in his name.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis, Archbishop Lucas, Father Joe, and all church leaders, may God give them strength as they work to lead his people. We pray to the Lord. For all who are persecuted for their Christian faith, so that they may draw strength from the cross of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For more vocations to the priesthood and religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For those suffering because of war and natural disasters, may they find the resources they need to rebuild their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they spend eternal life with God in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for Ron and Carol Misek. Today would have been their 49th wedding anniversary. Ronald died on October 7th, so today is a special day for them. We pray for them. We pray to the Lord. And we offer this Mass today for the living and deceased of the Germain and Alice Rohde family. We pray to the Lord. O God, our Father in heaven, please grant us these and all our needs, for which we pray to you today in Jesus' name, for he is Lord forever and ever. Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, with us bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer with humble and contrite hearts. Wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Perfect within us, O Lord, we pray, the solemn exchange brought about by these paschal offerings, that we may be drawn from earthly desires to a longing for the things of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and into willing to his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, again.
And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ. Blood of Christ. Please join me in making a spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you if you're already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Please join in singing number 167, Two Were Bound for Emmaus, number 167.
Let the
Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please join together in praying for the successful completion of our parish center. Loving Father, we come to you in adoration. May our hearts be open to your guidance on this journey. You have bestowed on your church community the gift to openly worship and praise your name. We humbly give thanks for the opportunity to serve you with our gifts and talents. Jesus, pour out your Holy Spirit as we gather in prayer to build a faithful parish center for all generations. O Sacred Heart of Jesus, pray for us. Blessed Virgin Mary, pray for us. Saint Isidore, pray for us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and grant you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia.
Closing song is number 171, Alleluia, Love is Alive, number 171.
Here, he is alive. Alleluia.
Today's Morning Mass is brought to you in part by these sponsors.